Hey guys, welcome to the alpha demo of Nioh. At least I'm assuming it's called Nioh, because that seems like a relatively straightforward pronunciation, but someone's gonna say that I'm just culturally insensitive and it's clearly pronounced turquoise or something, but it's a new game from Koei Tecmo and Team Ninja, and I like Team Ninja, so I'll check it out. People have been recommending it on the idea that it supposedly has something to do with Dark Souls, according to some people, but a lot of people just like to throw that comparison around wherever they feel like it, so who knows if that part's true. Look at this loading screen. Got a flame wolf with a sword. These little mushroom tree people. Aw, they're adorable. So here's an interesting thing. You can switch between movie mode and action mode. Movie mode stabilizes resolution. Action mode is good for frame rate. Supposedly the difference here is that one gives you 60 frames per second, the other one gives you 1080. Just to settle the dispute that people always have. Alright, let's get started. This product is still in development, and some features may differ from the final retail version. So many features. Kuroshima is a tiny island off the coast of Yusuki in Kyushu-Bugo province, or Bungo province. There's little in the way of usable land, with coastline rapidly giving way to cliffs and mountains. Clinging to its edge is the smallest of fishing villages, its residences eking out subsistence, farming on plots carved out of the hills. Their frugal lives stand in stark contrast to the village elder, whose opulent mansion perches atop the island's tallest peak, strangely oversized for the small island which it overlooks. Oh. Okay, I think I do understand why some people have been saying Dark Souls then. We have a body that seems to have a soul over it, and I have D-pad based controls on my screen already. Interesting. They've taken everything, they say. Oh no, why? Okay, yes, I understand the Dark Souls the Dark Souls comparison people have been doing. We've got poses, we've got 50 souls in the corner. I have a D-pad that seems to control this bottom left corner. So X square does the commands on the right as far as I can tell. Let's see. So square is punches. Y is kick. There is a straight up stamina meter. Circle doesn't do anything. X is a dash. Okay, yes. Serves me right for being suspicious about whether or not people were over-comparing to Dark Souls or not. Ooh! That seemed to give me even more level, even more souls. We can change our guardian spirit. What is our current one? Kato. We can do Isonade. Daibawashi, and Raiken. Differences here. Let's see here. So the current one gives me bonus spirit and close combat. Spirit protection, close combat attack. This one gives me sense enemies. Evasion key usage reduced. And dash endurance is reduced. A lot of options here. I assume I can click on them. It's just fine. Okay. Sense enemies could be interesting. I kind of wonder how that works. They have a bunch of different rules in the bottom about what impact it has on your attack enhancement and your recovery, your tenacity, and a bunch of other stats we don't necessarily fully understand. Alright, how your attack will be enhanced by a living weapon. Lightning indicates the power added to your attacks by a living weapon. Usable item, how long living weapon will last. Speed is might. Might is the speed at which a living weapon gauge decreases if you're hit. I think we should hold off on going too far into this before, until we find out what living weapon means first, because that's the recurring word they use for everything. I need 250 Amrita to level up, so we can't level up yet. Summon Visitor. We have 3 Ochoka cups in our possession. We're not currently offering one. I'm curious. So we can a small ceramic cup for drinking sake. Using it to make an offering at the shrine will summon a visitor. When the visitor arrives, it will take a cup. Alright. So that's just gonna stay here until I stop it. We'll see how that goes. So we have a block button, as expected. Left trigger doesn't do anything. If I hold... Can I hold down? Yes, if you hold down the dodge button, you'll run. Interesting. There's a lot of little details to figure out. The camera's very fast to rotate, by the way. Once I find an enemy, we'll have to see if it locks on with right stick or not. Yep, it does. Oh. I should have found out how to equip my sword. Ow. Yeah, that was a mistake. Freed from this mortal coil. I should actually put my weapon on. There we go. The touchpad is how you open the menu. Start is how you emote for whatever reason. Alright. Melee weapon. Bison Den Ujigadana. Alright. Use the D-pad to change weapons in and out, as you'd expect. There we go. Now I'll be able to fight back properly. I may have gone past my mind a little bit. So we do leave stuff at our corpse, too. Yeah, absolutely. This is a company being like, I'm gonna get in on that Dark Souls noise that all the kids seem to like these days. I'll say that if there's any time to get Dark Souls likes coming out on a regular basis, it's pretty much now, because Dark Souls 3 is supposed to be the last game. According to Miyazaki, the creative director or lead designer or whatever we call them at From Software, the makers of Dark Souls 3, well, Dark Souls everything, Demon's Souls Bloodborne, Hello. Is this how somebody died? Bloody Grave, level 7. You can fight the Revenant impaled by an outlaw. According to them, they have... Oh! Ha! Not sure what I was expecting there. We're learning things. I'm willing to show most of my failures here and whatnot just because this is a brand new thing and we don't know what we're looking at yet. And I'm curious about it. So at first glance, you would have probably thought, oh, it's a blood stain, so it's just going to show me how somebody dies. But obviously it also said fight Revenant to imply that something's going to happen. I didn't quite expect him to just get up right in front of me and immediately stab me with no warning. That was a bit of a shock for me. I think we got boots just now. We have Mariner's boots, so we can switch to the Sunnit foot soldier boots, which seem to have higher everything. Don't have any arm guards on. Alright, so this is like Samurai Dark Souls is what I would imply at this point. Makes me miss the fact that there hasn't been an Onimusha game in an incredibly long time. Alright, well that was my mistake. Yeah, the From Software has said that they don't currently have plans to make another Dark Souls. They're not counting out the possibility, because that would be irresponsible and they don't make weird declarations like that. But at the moment, they're not planning on it. Alright, so I'm going to summon this guy and then I'm going to run away instead of standing next to him this time. So it's a phantom of the guy that died? Oop. So it's a player phantom, basically. Except that it's not actually a player, though, in that it's not currently being controlled one, as far as I can tell. Otherwise, that'd be some really fast matchmaking if he got in that fast. Ow. I tried to dash behind him using Dark Souls logic and may not apply here. One of the obvious dangers of playing games like this is trying to over-apply your gaming strategies you use in the other game. Because just because they might have similarities doesn't mean that the same things work. Alright, I should be blocking. Let's try blocking a bit. Did I take any damage? I was watching the actual action in front of me. Let's see. Do I take any damage? No, I don't. It takes stamina out and that's it. Ow! And that is how you die. They have the very easy deaths part down. There we go. You might be thinking, oh, well you've done like 7 playthroughs of Dark Souls games, obviously you're just going to wreck this game. Not exactly. It definitely feels very different. It is its own game in that aspect. It's using obvious visual similarities and design concepts with the souls and the combat and everything and the lock-on and stuff, but it feels very different. And that's a whole different thing to learn. So what's the deal with these guys? They died here in the water. Did something attack you in the water? It was killed by... Doesn't say who it was killed. Oh, they drowned. How'd they drown? Oh, they must have gone in the water. Don't do that. Don't die in the water. Oh, hi, friend. Probably should have locked on a little bit instead of attacking the air next to him. Alright, dashing was less than bell. Oh, interesting. I just realized something really important. There's a certain tactical advantage to the fact that you can see your opponent's stamina bar. Which is not something I'm used to. Since you can see their stamina bar, that means you know exactly when you're likely to overcome them. Interesting. We're picking up items from corpses, and the corpses are actually... It's like we're getting the mournful thoughts of the dead. I got new arm guards, right? Foot soldier arm guards. Yeah, we're getting the mournful thoughts of the dead around here when I loot their corpses. There's a little voiceover saying, if only I could have fought back, and stuff like that. So it's not the last thoughts, it's the last thoughts if they lay dying for a while. I'll kill the bastards myself. Yeah, maybe it is our last thoughts then. Maybe that guy was laying there dying and was thinking, if only I could have fought back better, whereas this guy is like, I'll kill it myself, and he probably died abruptly and didn't have another thought after that. But since I can see their stamina meter, that means that I can actually know whether or not I'm likely to overwhelm them, which is interesting. Because Dark Souls has mechanics like that, but I've generally found it not entirely useful to try to exert... I don't always find it useful to try to exhaust somebody's stamina. In PvP, it's obviously useful, because you have an idea of what the limitations of a player might be. But in PvE, against random enemies, you don't really know if it's even reasonable to try to... Oopsie, I was trying to pick up an item. That's worrying. They gave them both the same button prompt. See, so does up on D-pad heal me? There we go, that's how you use your... whatever item I have equipped there. Don't mind me, just want to pick up this item. There we go. Friend. I'm gonna die here. Ow. Did not escape in the middle of that. Oh, yeah, he looks dangerous. Oh, is he down? Oh, if there's backstabs, you don't do them like that. I was doing something wrong there. I should probably get more distance before I try to heal. Hey, friend. Gonna bait out the attacks a little bit. Oh. Oh, well. Completely squandered that. Alright, so at this point, I would say you probably can't dodge out of a combo. So that's one habit to squash right there, is don't try to dodge out of a combo the way you can in certain other game I keep mentioning. By the way, if you're new around here for some reason, and you're wondering why I keep mentioning Dark Souls, it's only because I have hundreds of episodes of that stuff on this channel. So my existing audience is going to expect me to discuss this in the context of Dark Souls, whether or not you find that annoying or not. I know people are always like, you should let every game go by its own right or whatever the hell. And I agree with that, but I'm still going to compare them. I'm not going to be like, this game's bullshit because it's not Dark Souls, but I'm going to still talk about them in contrast, because that's how criticism works. And I am curious about this game. Picked up something new to... Oh! Elixir, stone, simple rock, perfect size for throwing, tiny crystal, oh, that you can turn into souls, basically, the Amrita. Amrita. See, I just set this as another shortcut. My question would be, how do I change my shortcuts, though? Because up on the D-pad heals me. That is my headdress. I don't actually know how to, change my shortcuts right now. My durability of my weapon is going down according to that meter, if that is durability meter. That's noteworthy. Alright, so I should probably hold off on summoning opponents, because they're clearly more dangerous than the regular foes, and we're getting extra time added to it. Ow. Aggroing both at once was a mistake. Nope. So something I'm very quickly learning that I need to adapt to, and I started this thought and didn't follow it up properly, is the idea that you can't really dodge out of stuff the way I'm used to. In Dark Souls, the first thing I do if I start getting hit is hit that dodge button, because you'll probably escape the combo. But as far as I can tell so far, If you're hitting your opponent, they can't really escape, and if they're hitting you, you can't really escape. What I need to start trying to do to experiment is when my opponent's attacking me, I need to start hitting block and see if the block is how I break the combo, because that's the obvious other option to go for. Because I'm hammering away at that dodge button and it is not making me escape their combo. Oh, hey! The rock is on my right D-pad now. That answers that question. It does 50 damage, which is generally garbage, I'm sure. Yeah. But it primarily is useful for making the enemy approach you from a distance. So that means you can assign 3 hotkeys then to up, right, and down, I assume? And whereas left changes your weapon. So this is probably a no-shield game. So it may take more after Bloodborne than anything. Oh! That guy does not get stunned by being impaled by a sword, which is a surprising trait for a human being with a fleshy body. That's fine, though. You can see my habits, my bad habits are constantly showing here. Even when I'm acknowledging the fact that blocking is probably a bigger emphasis in this game than dodging, I still keep hitting dodge constantly. But yeah, next time I get hit by a series of blows, I need to try to avoid it with a block to see if I can break the combo. So there's a drop-off point down here, and an ambush of some kind. No, that's the same guy we fought before. So there's no reason to go down there right now, besides probably having an advantage to attack him from that angle, if I hadn't already done so. That's worrying, they're telling me how to block now. I guess you probably could have gotten through those guys without blocking at all. I'm probably experimenting with concepts in my head that the game doesn't expect me to be thinking about immediately. But I am. I always am. Ooh, charge stance. Alright. So he thought somebody was too young. So I have my normal attack is our square, but if I hold R1... Ooh, what happened there? So I attacked a few times, my stamina partly depleted, then I used R1, and it seemed to give me an instant refresh of some kind? I'm not really sure. Anyway, triangle. Enters me into this stance. Oh, it's a change stance, not charge stance. So R1 switches you between these different stances. Oh, hi, Spearman. So now I'm in lowered blade view. Oh, excuse me. Bad time to be attacked. I was experimenting with movesets. Oh. That one seems to have faster movesets. Lower damage, though. Switch to my normal stance for now. Oh, finish this guy off. Here we go. Alright, so let's experiment a little bit. So here's my standard stance. It's R1 plus square. But then R1 with triangle seems to be the more aggressive stance. The raised blade. It's all about heavy but slow swings. And then this lower one is probably smaller, lower damage, maybe even lower range, but faster attacks. It does seem to be exceptionally fast with relatively low stamina cost too. And circle just seems to shield your sheath your sword, which may or may not serve any actual purpose. I think it was mostly just because they wanted to have that nice little 4-point diagram in the corner of the 4 directions you put your sword in, and have that look cool. Alright, I'll experiment with the heavy swings for a bit, after I heal real quick. So only time will tell. This game has some of the combat systems and the experience systems, but only time will tell if this game has interesting level design to it, or if it's just sort of a bunch of open plains. Because I would love to see another game that uses the design sensibilities of a game like Dark Souls for its level design, with its interfolding levels. That's like the one thing that that was actually surprisingly well done. Oops. This will take some practice. That was the one thing that was surprisingly well done in Lords of the Fallen, a game that I think was probably our first attempt at having a super similar Dark Souls game. Like they tried super hard to get the entire system down there. But, it was kind of crap, honestly. But I think the one thing that they did nail was that it was surprising how interlocked and interwoven and how many shortcuts and backpaths and how complicated the map became as you explored it. It had that fully fledged like 3D Metroidvania design to it that I found very satisfying, and that has only really been properly pulled off by Dark Souls games, even though there have been 3D Castlevania games. I will say I've never played Metroid Prime, so I don't know if they nailed it or not, because they could have too. They probably did. I think I've heard that. There we go. But we're not nearly far enough to be thinking too much about the level design here. So I've barely progressed so far, but death should be expected in a game like this. Friend. Well, at least the throw aiming is consistent. At this moment, it has that over Dark Souls, technically. Alright, so I let my stamina run out, which was a massive mistake. And apparently there's a huge punishment for that, because if you get hit when your stamina's down, you actually get knocked down entirely. Ooh, his head came clean off. Yay! My favorite part was the murder. Hi. You have any more friends, or is it just you this time? Oh, I did not mean to heal. I meant to switch to my other stance. Mixing of which side of the screen does what there. Costly effect. Gotta be careful about my stamina here, because I'm using the strength moves. It seems like there's not much of an expense. The game does not seem to punish you immediately for running out of stamina. It seems like it's more likely to punish you if you try to do an action after you run out of stamina. Well, by that I mean, like, it seems like the action that depletes your stamina doesn't seem to actually hurt you yet. But once you try to make that mistake again, you seem to be in trouble. Oh, interesting. I just got a spear. So we're not completely restricted to using samurai swords in this game, which I was honestly considering as a possibility. Alright, so here's my personal favorite type of weapon in video games. Any kind of quarterstaff or spear is always something I'm a fan of, usually. Let's avoid the phantoms. A lot of people dying everywhere, apparently. But I don't need to spend more time with them, I don't think. Look at that! Look at this running stance! That's funny. It seems like a reasonable charge stance, to some extent. It's just you never see it animated quite that way in these kinds of games. Oh! That sounds like an ambush to me. Just gonna back up a second. Oh, that's them all noticing me. I will say, I think with the spear, you're supposed to stab them, not flail around like a crazy. Maybe sweat. Oh, three of them at once. That's not good. It'd probably be a good idea to back up a bit. Oh! Danger. The learning curve is strong with this one. Oh well, we'll probably respawn peacefully on the beach where I can experiment with my spear, which is what interests me most at this point. So, here's our normal swing combo. It's currently three swings, and that's it, I believe. I think that's all my stamina can muster. Yeah. Oh no. Yeah. Even if you have your stamina, it only does three in a row. We'll try the fast ones. If it is fast in this case. Oh wow. Wow. Look at the Dynasty Warriors character we're playing as all of a sudden. Zhao Yun, is that you? And here's our strength stance. Whoa. There's the full extent of your attack range, huh? And Yep. That's just sheathing your weapon in a circle, which is amusing to me. Having that attention to detail is kind of funny to me, because yeah, like that's an ongoing thing with any sort of samurai related game is the dramatic putting away of your weapon animation. Oh shoot! All right, be careful. You have to be careful here with the fact that the weapon doesn't necessarily auto lock onto your opponent. You have to press that direction. Otherwise, I am in trouble. All right, a little bit cumbersome with that stance. The sheer speed of this could be amusing. A lot of attacks you can do with low stamina, but you have to worry about not really getting your opponent to die, which could be a very real risk. Let's try spear on spear action over here. Hey, buddy. In this particular case, it seems like having a fast stance probably gives you an advantage against somebody that's using their big, slow spear attacks. I wonder if that might... There might even be a dynamic in this game, for all I know, where there might be the three specific stances for the purpose of rock, paper, scissors. I'm just kind of hypothesizing about random stuff right now, but it's totally possible that the game would be like, hey, three different stances! You gotta detect which one your opponent's using and figure out how to counter it. I'm hoping we find a shock, some kind of, out of here. Okay, I'm noticing a problem with this attack is that I miss sometimes. Oh, switch back to my sword on accident. I'll just commit to that for now. So interestingly, when you switch stances with one weapon, you stay in that stance with the other weapon. This thing might be the game's equivalent of a bonfire. No, it says search. Nope, just more. So you get something called a key pulse if you press your stance button after attacking. So that's what that is, apparently? I'm not sure, actually. I'm trying to keep an eye on my stamina to see how it works. Here, we'll let it fully regenerate. We'll attack for a bit to really eat away at it. Yeah, I don't know. Not sure if I fully understand what they're talking about there. Because you can sort of recharge it, but it doesn't really seem to enable me to do much unless I don't understand what it is. It's probably a good idea to stick to my spear for a bit. Oh. There's a shack in the woods that have an item that this guy thought he could use to fight back. And he failed. But it's worth considering. Hey, friend. Come and get me. Poke. I am somewhat disappointed that this spear is used as a bow staff more than a actual spear. Not a lot of stabbing going on. They went full Dynasty Warriors with this moveset to not use it as the thrusting weapon it's designed to be. When my gauge is full, press circle and triangle to use a living weapon. Uh-oh. Careful. Stamina, why? There we go. The Amita gauge. So which one of those is that, exactly? Body, heart, stamina, strength, skill, dexterity, life, and ki. So ki is our stamina in this game. I don't know how to use my Amrita. Oh, top left corner. The glyph up there is filling up vertically. That's got to be the triangle and circle button setup we have. There's a lot of directions to go in so far. I'm heading down here for arbitrary reasons. Oop, that's a drop-off point, so if I go down there, I'm not coming back. Oop, and there I go. That seems an awful lot like it might be our starting point of the entire game. And that is a ladder. Oh. The shortcut back to this point. That's handy. There's definitely an element of paying attention to some part of From Software right here, then. If we're having a ladder that I can kick down. On top of having a bunch of corpses. Here we go. I might be able to actually level up now. Pull the ladder! So they were shouting at them to pull the ladder to try to block off that passageway before somebody could pursue them. It's kind of cool how this is all contextualized as being like maybe some kind of rival clan was attacking, and then everything around here is like the final thoughts of various people dying, basically. Is there anything out here in this boat, or am I gonna drown? Yeah, I'm gonna drown. So no. None of that right now. Let's go ahead and visit our shrine. We'll see how that goes. There we go. So we're having a hint of a Dark Souls-ish level design there, where we go around and then you open up a shortcut and continually use one bonfire to explore. Alright. You have my attention. I put a cup down before, but it seems like would I be offering another one here? Yeah. Oh no, it says stop offering, so I think I still am offering. I think just no one's come to my game yet. Presumably, that might mean you can co-op in this game, but I don't know if that feature's even unlocked in this game, in the current alpha that I'm playing. Offer an item to receive, I mean, oh, that's how you sell items, basically.